On the following day, all the junk is in the bottom of the flask and the gold solution is ready to be filtered. It is highly recommended using a proper laboratory filter and not store-bought coffee filters. I'm using medium slow speed filters, which will strain any solid particle over 5 microns. The fluted filter paper sets in the funnel as soon as it gets wet. First, the bulk of the gold solution, which is free and clear of solid particles, is poured to the filter. This portion will run down very fast. Here in the flask, you can see the remaining junk. I'll just wash it several times with water and pour it down the filter. The bulk of the solids are left in the flask. Please remember to wash the filter with plenty of water so that all of the yellow gold-bearing solution will run down into the receiving flask. When you are done, the filter should be white again. Our next step is to remove the gold from the solution. This is done by using sodium metabisulfite, or in short, SMB. The SMB is first dissolved in water and then added to a stirred gold solution. The SMB will react with the gold ions in the solution and reduce it to metallic gold powder. As a result, some sulfur dioxide gas will release. It's pretty toxic, so the reaction must be done under a fume hood. By the way, you don't really have to use a magnetic stirrer like in this video. It is just my personal favorite. The solution is again left to settle overnight. Here you can see the gold powder all settled to the bottom of the flask, and the supernatant is practically colorless. This is a good indication for purity. The bulk of the solution is slowly decanted and the washing cycles begin. The washing cycles are extremely important if commercially pure gold is wanted. Starting with a simple tap water wash, the gold powder is covered with boiling hot water, swirled for a while, and left to cool back down. This water wash is repeated 2 more times. Take note of the color of the gold powder prior to the acid wash. Now for the acid wash, the powder is simply covered with hydrochloric acid 32% and brought to a gentle boil. Take note of the color of the solution. The acid dissolves traces of copper, nickel, and silver chloride, and it will also dissolve some gold. The acid wash is left to cool down and later decanted. The process is repeated until the acid wash doesn't gain any color anymore. It usually takes 3 to 5 washes. In between each acid wash, it would be a good idea to do a quick water wash so that a better indication of color change can be seen on the next wash. I like to keep the acid washes in a separate container and use it later to dissolve more dirty gold. Take a close look at the powder after the acid washes. The color is clearly lighter, which is another good indication for purity. The powder is later washed several times with distilled water and placed on a hot plate to slowly dry out. And here's the result. I hope you found this demonstration useful and interesting. Please comment, share, and subscribe. Oh, and by the way, click here to jump over to the melting video.